last those council meetings. I'd die of old age before my colleagues ran out of things to say.
Have you always felt this way about your fellow masters?
Don't misunderstand. They're good people. I just prefer to get things done. This situation has come to you fast. You're braving dangers many Jedi never face. I wouldn't blame you for having questions. This may be the only time to ask them.
I get the impression you haven't had a Padawan for years. Why did you ask to train me?
As Jedi, you learn to trust your instincts. When I met you in that cave, my instincts told me that I was meant to train you. I don't know why or for what purpose, but the Living Force brought us together for a reason.
I look forward to learning from you.
I expect you have things to teach me as well. Let's get to work. There's a group of Twi'lek pilgrims on Tython. They've been fighting the Flesh Raiders for months. The Republic asked us to deny those Twi'lek's aid. They settled here illegally, but frankly, we need them.
How are they violating the law?
When Tython was first rediscovered, the Twi'leks petitioned the Senate to settle here. Their claim was denied, too dangerous. But they came anyway. The Twi'leks have a settlement in the mountains. That's your next stop. Establish a base camp and speak to the Matriarch. Find out everything the Twi'leks know about Flesh Raiders.
I'm ready to get back out there, do some good.
I'll join you soon. May the Force be with you.
Safe out there.
Greetings, Matriarch. Master Orgus Din has sent me to help you fight the Flesh Raiders.
So the Jedi finally deign to recognize my people's suffering. How noble. Nothing to do with the attack on your training grounds, I'm sure.
We didn't realize how great a threat the Flesh Raiders had become.
And now you seek help from the people you once ignored. My scouts have tracked the Flesh Raiders for months, watched them grow in strength. I will share what we've discovered, but only if you agree to protect my people. We suffer.
Mother, you need rest. Let me carry this burden for you.
The Matriarch appears sick. Does she need a doctor?
Thank you, but we have our own healers.
This is my daughter, Rana Dalven. She and Scout Chief Morint here will speak for me. I must attend to other matters.
Personally, I don't care why you've come. As long as you destroy the Flesh Raiders. Ever since they got their new weapons and gear, they hunt us like animals. The enemy has a camp in the valley nearby. My scouts say the Flesh Raiders store their weapons and other tech in a cave.
Removing that technology will neutralize the Flesh Raiders.
We need to strike fear into the Flesh Raiders, sabotage their weapons. Fix it so they blow up in their ugly faces.
How would we do that?
Their technology is standard Republic design. We could overload the power circuits and plasma coils. Here, I'll show you. Sabotage would thin the Flesh Raider numbers and eliminate their technological advantage.
If you brought that technology here, we could defend ourselves with those weapons.
This village is vulnerable to attack. You need better defenses.
This debate is pointless unless you can get inside that cave. You'll need one of the leader's access keys.
Find the Flesh Raider technology and do what you think is best. Good luck, Master Jedi.
More young Jedi in Kalikori, I see. I am Yulaf Fon, Master of Rituals. I welcome you. You wish to participate in the ceremony, I presume? You understand the dangers?
I'm sorry. I don't know what you're talking about.
You've not been told, then. I apologize. Many of your brethren, your Padawans, come to Kalikori to perform our rite of passage. Those who endure the ceremony are awarded an audience with Kolovish to receive her wisdom and her gifts.
Why would Jedi participate in pilgrim rituals?
To prove their strength, to gain rewards, to show friendship. Kolovish lives in the mountains above. Once our leader, now she is our guide and protector. To complete the ceremony, you must walk the 1,000 steps to her home. You must carry a burning brand and light the signals along the path. You must protect the flame from beasts and flesh raiders. This will prove your worth. If you wish, I will ignite the brand. It burns only a short while. But if you are deserving, it will be enough.
I'm ready to carry the flame.
Then go, and light each of the signal fires along the mountain path. When you reach the end, you will find Kolovish.
Thank you. perform the rite of the pilgrims well, Jedi. I saw the signal fires as you climbed the path. Very few of your kind make it this far. I am Kalovish, first matriarch and reader of the ancient texts. I led our people to this planet, and I welcome you.
It's a privilege to meet you, Matriarch.
And it is my privilege to meet a Jedi who accepts our ways. Even our own kind, the other Twi'leks, they mocked us and denied the authority of the Matriarchs. That is why we came here. Now you've completed the ritual, and you are friend to the pilgrims. You share our burdens, and you share our strength.
I'm tremendously honored.
Take these gifts. We have very little, as you must know. But you are Jedi. You share our world, and you face a difficult future.
What makes you think that?
It is the way of Jedi to face darkness. I believe you will face the darkness of our world, and perhaps beyond. Go to your duties now, and as we part, know that my blessings go with you.
Once they have all this, the Twi'leks can defend themselves. Don't worry, little guy. I'll get you out of here. Good thing the Flesh Raiders don't eat droids.
Teach our soldiers how to use these weapons. Train them on the Twi'lek invaders.
When will we strike against the Jedi?
Patience, Caliph. The Jedi will fall when our army reaches full strength.
I never understood the need for restraining bolts anyway.
She died in my arms. You should have seen what those filth did to her.
I'm sorry, Seilu. We all share your loss.
For every one of us the Flesh Raiders butcher, we should kill 10. No, 100!
Will that restore your loved one to life?
Don't lecture me, Jedi. My wife is dead. Our people slaughtered. Where were you then?
Nothing I say will ever make you feel whole again. But we truly are doing everything we can.
What about exterminating those animals? The Flesh Raiders won't stop until we're all dead. Are you going to let that happen?
I won't quit until the Flesh Raiders are defeated. That's a promise.
We'll see what a Jedi's promise is worth.
I hope you can fulfill that pledge. I fear he won't take disappointment well. People wonder why Jedi are forbidden to marry or have families. They don't see how attachments always lead to suffering. Passionate emotions can destroy a person, and Jedi destroyed by passion become something terrible.
This droid says he works for the Jedi. Is that true?
Yes, he's one of our long-range probes. We sent out 20. This is the only one to come back. While I deal with a droid, talk to Rana. I think her people are ready to help us, thanks to you.
With the weapons and technology you brought from the Flesh Raiders, my people can defend themselves. You risked your life to help us. My people haven't had a champion for some time.
Jedi have a duty to protect and defend others.
And we promise to share our knowledge in return for that duty.
Scouts report that the Flesh Raider forces are gathering in strength. They already control the mountains around us, and now they're invading the ruins of Kaleth. My men spotted them at the remains of an ancient shrine, close to your Jedi temple.
Kaleth was a great city of Force users. Its ruins hold powers we still don't understand.
The Flesh Raiders are looking for something there.
We can't let them find it. Drive back those Flesh Raiders immediately. I have to take this droid back to the Council. That hooded figure in the holo, I know his voice. The situation is worse than I thought. Do whatever it takes to push the Flesh Raiders out of Kaleth. I'll send you reinforcements as soon as possible.
I'll hold the line until reinforcements arrive, Master.
If you see that hooded figure from the holo, do not engage him. I get going.
Jedi.
Did you just call me Jedi?
Master Orgas sent us. We came as quickly as we could.
One of the Flesh Raiders I just fought called me Jedi. He could use the Force.
That's troubling. If the Flesh Raiders are learning the ways of the Force, it won't be on the side of light.
You sure made short work of this bunch. You ever leave survivors?
When was the last time you fought someone trying to kill you?
Besides my master? A few months.
This is no laughing matter, Padawans. This Flash Raider carried a holocron, a repository of knowledge created by a Force user. Thousands of years old from the looks of it. Master Orgas was right. These natives are more advanced than we realized. They're learning how to fight us.
Master Orgas thinks he knows who's behind it.
I gathered as much, but he had no time to explain before sending us here. I wish we could stay. See this through, but Master Satil has ordered us to Coruscant on a special mission.
All those bad feelings the Council's been having? She thinks the Republic capital is the source.
I'm sorry to have to leave you, but the danger is past. These surveillance monitors will keep watch on Kaleth, place them around the ruins. The Temple can then monitor any future incursions by our enemies.
What are we prepared to do if the Flesh Raiders return?
The Temple's guards will respond to any invasion, and these surveillance devices will give us ample warning. May the Force be with you, Padawan.